I came to CES hoping to see one particular kind of display technology. And after 4 days of it eluding me, I was starting to give up hope. But then, you guys, I found it. I found what I was looking for, and I think you're gonna be extremely excited to hear about it. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Caleb Dennison, and we are wrapping up our CES coverage. I was just about to take my bags to the airport when I heard that something I was looking for was actually at the show. So we rushed over to see it, and I can't wait to show you. I'm not gonna hold all you TV enthusiasts any longer. What I'm talking about is QDEL, or QDEL technology, also known as quantum dot electroluminescent display. That's right, folks, it exists. And not only does it exist, it turns out it's scalable and fairly easy to manufacture. But I'll get into those details in just a moment. For those of you who don't know what the heck I'm talking about when I say QDEL, let me give you a little bit of a display primer. We've got, in one camp, LCD televisions, right? These are the LED or mini LED TVs or QLED TVs or ULED TVs. These are TVs that use an LED backlight of some sort with an LCD panel in front of it to make a picture. They are backlit TVs. They are also known as transmissive in that they don't make their own light. Then we have our emissive displays. That would include OLED, QD OLED, and micro LED, where the pixels themselves make their own light. There is no backlight involved whatsoever. And we've enjoyed these displays for the past several years because they offer true black levels, infinite contrast, and very high color luminance as well. Now, it used to be that OLED-based displays didn't get very bright, but over the years, we've seen them getting brighter and brighter and brighter. So that advantage that LED-based TVs held over OLED started to kind of disappear. But OLED is an organic material, and as such, it is going to wear out over time. It does have some risk for burn-in, and its longevity is not as great as a mini LED TV with an LCD panel. Now, today's QLED TVs and QD OLED TVs, which we consider to be the pinnacle of each type of display technology, share one thing in common, and that is the Q, quantum dots. Quantum dots are tiny little nanoparticles that, well, until now, have glowed when you shine light on them. What quantum dots bring to the table is very high color purity and great efficiency. When you add them to a display, things get much more vibrant and colorful. Now, as TV enthusiasts for a very long time now have been hoping that we would one day see a fully emissive quantum dot display. That means that the quantum dots at work in this display would not need some other light shown on them to activate them. They would be activated by electricity and glow on their own. This would also be an emissive display with perfect black levels and excellent color purity, but without all the disadvantages that might come with an organic material that's in an OLED-based television. And also without all the problems that come with having an LCD panel. Now, it's important to make a distinction here. In both QD OLED and QLED TVs, quantum dots are implemented as a film, right? They print them on a piece of film, stick them in the panel, and they do their job from there. QDEL is an entirely different animal. These quantum dots are going to be combined with an active TFT matrix, and they will shine on their own. And folks, I feel like I've come way too far already without mentioning that it is Sharp Display Corporation that has made this happen. That's right, Sharp has taken the materials that it's gotten from Nanosys, which makes the quantum dot stuff, and they have finally developed a QDEL display that works on their IGZO TFT matrix technology. IGZO, some of you guys may remember from years and years ago, is something that Sharp has patented and used for a long time. Now they can take these quantum dots and use them with their own active matrix and have a fully emissive quantum dot display. No organic compounds, no LEDs, just quantum dots. And folks, we're talking about the pinnacle of color purity. Nothing should be able to touch it. If you were to chart out the red, green, and blue on a graph, they would have the most pure peaks we've ever seen from any display technology ever. And what you're seeing right now is the proof of that concept. It is a small 12.3-inch screen. The box that you see underneath it is the power supply and kind of the processing stuff. It's a prototype. Keep in mind, we're in a tiny little back room where secrets are being discussed. This isn't the big show floor where we get to see a whole bunch of transparent OLEDs in a gigantic display. We're in a tiny room where Sharp is letting everybody know that it's got this technology and it's ready to go. And that's perhaps the most exciting thing about this. They tell me that unlike OLED, you don't need a very special room to create these panels. OLED requires a vacuum. You actually have to change the atmosphere in order to produce OLED panels, and that's a big part of the cost involved in making OLED panels. Apparently, this QDEL or QDEL display can be made in the same manufacturing facilities as regular LCD displays. In fact, the same machinery can be used. So it's not like they have to reinvent the wheel or build new manufacturing plants. They can start making this stuff right now. The other important part of this is that it's scalable. Sure, what they're showing us right now in this prototype is a small 12-inch display, but they also showed me a working 30-inch display that some engineer basically put together in a lab back in Japan. So they're proving that the technology works, and they're proving that it can be scaled up. Now, what happens? I know a lot of you want to know when this is going to be in your next TV, and we don't know that. I don't think Sharp knows that. That depends on Sharp's customers. Sharp sees itself right now deploying this maybe first as a mobile technology. Maybe it is going to be the new display in your wearable watch. Maybe it appears in a phone. They also will probably go after IT-based displays, so your laptops and maybe your computer monitors. But if some electronics company out there wants to make this happen bad enough and soon enough, the technology can be made. So it's really outside of Sharp Display Corporation's hands in terms of how long it is that we have to wait to see this in an actual television. Now, that's all of the information that I have, which I gotta say, I think is plenty of information. We wanted to know if QDEL was possible. We wanted to know if anybody was working on it. We wanted to know if maybe there was a prototype. Has it been made to work yet? It has. We know that now, and we know that this technology is going to be coming to us in the years to come. Now, there is a special conference called SID that's going to take place later this year, and I do think that Sharp is going to present some advancements in this technology at that show. That's a show that I don't normally go to, but you can bet I'm gonna go to that show this year just to see this technology in action. And that's it, folks. I'm super excited to have found this. I am super excited to be one of the few who actually got to show it to you. I think that is a perfect way to wrap up CES. This is the stuff I live for, the little backroom secret technology that literally defines the future, in this case, in terms of displays. Thanks as always for watching, everyone. What do you think of this video? Leave me a comment down below. Tell me all about it. Smash it with a like if you appreciate this kind of reporting. Don't forget to subscribe, ring that notification bell. I'll see you on the next video. And until then, here's two other videos I think you might like.